The Ozark Hellbender is one of our largest species of salamanders found in the state.
This aquatic salamander probably won't win any animal beauty contests. It lacks the star power of big Arkansas mammals like the black bear or elk. And since it isn't a species that's sought by hunters and anglers, it's largely unknown to most of the state's sportsmen. But that doesn't mean we can ignore the Ozark Hellbender.
With all species, whether you hunt or fish for them, every species has evolved to serve a function in our ecosystems.
With its small, beady eyes, flattened head and body, and wrinkled folds of slimy skin, the Ozark Hellbender doesn't usually invoke warm and fuzzy feelings. It's speculated that the animal's common name was coined by early settlers who thought the creature looked like it had emerged from the netherworld and was bent on returning there.
Because they are different, most folks don't understand when they bring them in on rod and reel, which they are occasionally taken. What is this crazy, ugly looking animal? They don't know what it is, so they don't understand it. So getting the word out to try to let folks know we have this unique species that's found only in the Ozarks of Arkansas and Missouri to try to help us conserve it for the future generations.
Hellbender conservation faces steep challenges. The Ozark Hellbender only exists in a handful of Ozark streams in southern Missouri and northeastern Arkansas. Populations are in sharp decline, and in October 2011, the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service placed the Ozark Hellbender on the federal endangered species list.
Over the years, changes in the habitat and also we think potentially impacts from disease or other factors that we haven't been able to nail down have caused populations of the animals to decline dramatically.
The 11 Point River in Randolph County harbors Arkansas's only remaining Ozark Hellbender population that's robust enough to support research. The 11 Point flows out of the Missouri Ozarks before meeting the Spring River southwest of Pocahontas.
Now, I began a long-term monitoring program of our Ozark Hellbender population in the 11 Point River in 2005.
Irwin isn't getting his hands on as many Hellbenders now as he did when the program started. This year, his crew found a total of 29 Hellbenders. The average for the biannual survey has been about 40. So why should anyone be concerned about the decline of this unsightly amphibian?
All these species are very important. The more species we have in our ecosystems, the healthier that ecosystem is. Every species is important, equally so, whether you hunt or fish for them or not. All those other pieces or species in our ecosystems are indicators of the health of those ecosystems. As we lose more species, the less healthy those ecosystems are.
And if that isn't enough to persuade sportsmen to get behind Hellbender conservation, consider this.
As the Hellbender goes, so goes the quality of your fisheries resource. The habitats that the Hellbenders use are the deeper, faster waters with the big rocky structure that the Hellbenders hide under. Those rock structures are what things like the smallmouth and walleye and other fishes that are sport fished for utilize for their structure too.
It's a type of habitat that's slowly disappearing.
The river's stream bed is being filled in with a lot of runoff from all the little feeder tributaries. This is not an indictment, but an observation that as more land has been cleared to put into hay fields or for cow pastures, the speed with which water runs off the surrounding hillsides increases dramatically. Where it used to be a forested habitat, this increased speed of water movement from all these tributaries then downcuts and erodes the banks of all the feeder streams. And this effectively smothers the large rocky boulder habitat that the Hellbenders need.
Habitat loss isn't the only problem for Ozark Hellbenders.
And this is a fungal disease that we know is present in the river and on the animals, but we have not been able to detect that this is causing a direct death as a result of this disease.
As the Arkansas Game and Fish Commission's herpetologist, Kelly Irwin is leading the agency's charge to study Ozark Hellbenders and restore their populations. He conducts population surveys every other year on the 11 Point River, searching under rocks, collecting data, and doing extensive disease testing.
That's what I contend is scar tissue.
Irwin and his crews also place artificial structures in the river to bolster the Hellbender's natural habitat. It's all a part of the plan to save the Ozark Hellbender and preserve a piece of the natural state's natural history.
They've been around a long time. We found fossil evidence of this particular group of salamanders that goes back to 25 million years ago in the Central Plains. So this lineage is very ancient, and it's important, again, as I've already mentioned, the fact that the more components we can maintain in our ecosystem, the healthier it is.
You're looking fine.
Keeping tabs on the endangered Ozark Hellbender isn't the easiest work.
You're dealing with fairly cool water, so you're always wearing wetsuits. We wear 50 pounds of lead just to get us down and hold us on the bottom. You know, you're dealing in some instances with fairly fast current. You're down there lifting large 200-pound rocks to try to anchor things in or install the Hellbender huts, or just looking for animals. You're down there underwater. You're really working your body a lot, and it's not easy. So it's not for the meek and mild-mannered, that's for sure.
For Kelly Irwin, the Arkansas Game and Fish Commission herpetologist, studying endangered salamanders requires a regular exercise regimen.
Yeah, it forces me to have to do exercises just so I can be in semi-shape to do the work each season. And I never used to have to work out. I just had to go to work. But nowadays, at my advanced age, I have to work out.
It's a labor of love, a passion that Irwin traces back to his childhood in northeastern Kansas.
I started poking around the old creek down by the house when I was 5 to 6 years old, and was just intrigued with the rat snakes and the snapping turtles and anything else, and the frogs that I found.
Irwin has been conducting research on the state's Ozark Hellbenders for a decade. The work takes place on northeastern Arkansas's 11 Point River, the endangered species' last bastion in the natural state. Using jet drive outboards to navigate the river's shoals, Irwin and his research crew travel to selected sites with Hellbender habitat. Their dive systems employ gas-powered air compressors on the boats and extended air lines that tether the divers to the boats. They systematically work back and forth over an imaginary grid on the stream bed, turning over rocks and collecting any Hellbenders they encounter. The Arkansas Game and Fish Commission has worked with numerous partners on Hellbender conservation, including the Missouri Department of Conservation and university researchers. Since the animal's listing on the endangered species list, the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service has played an increased role in monitoring efforts.
Did you say you did check those two boxes?
If the crews find Hellbenders, they began an extensive process of collecting various measurements.
390.
And taking disease samples.
This one back here, this right rear here.
Researchers have known for some time that Ozark Hellbenders are plagued by certain pathogens, including a fungal disease that may be linked to the animals developing lesions on their feet or losing their toes or an entire foot.
We think that perhaps this fungal disease might be involved in this loss of the toes and feet of the salamanders as a result, but we've not been able to get any data that shows this empirically.
We believe it's a result of the chytrid fungus, which breaks down the keratin. And this is the disease that's killing amphibians worldwide. But in these animals, we test positive for them, but we do not have any evidence that it kills them.
Each Hellbender is scanned for the presence of a previously implanted transponder that can help researchers track individual animals.
038.
If an animal hasn't been caught previously, Irwin inserts a transponder for future tracking.
I actually inject a small capsule that is into the base of the tail that is then scanned with a reader, which has a unique number on it. We can then come back years later and scan the animal, and we know exactly when and where we last caught it.
Over time, the information can help instruct management decisions.
You don't want to just go out and collect 2 years worth of data and make a conclusion based on that. And this allows us an ability to take these longer-term data and make more informed management decisions in directing our conservation efforts.
One relatively new conservation effort is the use of artificial habitat structures, commonly called Hellbender huts.
We actually physically take out and put in the river bottom and then weight them down with larger boulders to provide or supplement the existing habitat. We also utilize these boxes to hopefully recover some eggs to be put into the Hellbender Conservation Program at the St. Louis Zoo, which has had great success in the first captive breeding and rearing of Ozark Hellbenders.
The St. Louis Zoo's first successful Hellbender breeding took place in 2012. The long-term goal is to one day release the animals into the wild to supplement and sustain wild populations. Until then, scientists like Kelly Irwin will continue to search for answers, occasionally finding a glimmer of hope in the dark spots beneath the rocks on the bottom of the 11 Point River.
We do not find small or juvenile animals very often.
That's the first small one we've seen in years.
The take home though on this is still shows that the animals are still doing their best to reproduce within the past 2 to 3 years. So it's always a treat to find small juvenile individuals. And this again is not a common occurrence.
It's becoming less common in the case of the Ozark Hellbender. But that's what keeps people like Kelly Irwin on the front lines of conservation.
I would really hate to see Arkansas continue to lose its natural heritage due to the extinction of a species. Whether you are interested in reptiles, amphibians, birds, or mammals, it all is part of our natural heritage ecosystem process that we need to help conserve collectively. Not just individually as an employee of Game and Fish, but all citizens need to be concerned about this issue. Because without a natural environment, humans will have nothing to survive on.